Hi guys, Mitchell here at White Metal Games with an unboxing here. Let's see if you can get the box in frame. Wild West Exodus, we got this from War Cradle just about a week or two ago. We're going to open it up here and check it out. Good slipcover box. First off, you can tell there's a lot of weight to this box. It's very heavy. Feels pretty dense. Some good silver emboss in it. Gunfight at Red Oak. Starter set. Or Lawmen and Outlaws, I believe. Well, that's probably Lawmen here and Outlaws. So let's check it out. Got the back here, got a list of contents, some renders, very cool looking stuff. If you don't know about Wild West Exodus, it's first I thought it was steampunk Wild West or Weird West, but apparently it's a much more high-tech West. I don't think exists elsewhere in the system yet. Let's check her out. Slip cover here. Good size box. Again, with the embossing here, Wampus Exodus. Good high quality. Some little inserts here. For Wild West Exodus and their site and stuff. This is new War Cradle stuff. They just acquired Wild West Exodus. I guess it's them showing you where to find the information about the new branding and all that stuff. Rule book. Good heavy, high quality cardstock. Looks like full color. Yeah, all the way color. That's good. And it's not, feels very sturdy. Definitely not the cheap paper or anything. It's like a bunch of fluff about the factions, rules. Let's get to the sprues. That's plastic. I immediately recognize War Games Factory work here. That's plus one for me. I love their stuff. It's very dense sprue. Looks like a lot of cool, crisp detailing. Let's see, collect parts are numbered. That's great. Always fantastic. Frank James, Doc Holliday, Iron Horse, Wyatt Earp, Jesse James, Interceptor. Obviously, the two bikes. And the guys. Like the right amount of parts, not. It looks like the detailing is great on these things. Here on this body. Yeah, you can see really crisp details. So I'm very impressed, first off, from this stuff. It looks really good, actually. I'm getting a better look at it. Got the bandoliers on these guys, good. And with the individual bullets on those, I think. Very good. So this is our first offering in plastic, which I think it might be. This is very nice. Some more sprues. The attack dogs are separate sprues. Not War Games Factory. I don't recognize these. Who makes these? Still doesn't look any drop in quality though. And still feels like hard plastic. We have two different versions of attack dogs. Cybernetic attack dogs, apparently.
Cybernetic attack dogs?
Cybernetic attack dogs. Robot attack dogs.
That's awesome.
They're just comparing them. These are two obviously different company sprues, but the detailing doesn't look any different. It looks like they maintain quality across two different companies, so that's great. Comparing, looking to compare some of the rivet sizes here to there, and they still look. So it looks like they maintain a good cohesive quality across both of them. That's great. Let's clean up a little bit. got a lot of stuff in the box, which is nice to see. We got the bases. These Supercollectors have their own size bases. These are, you know, different kind of ovals than some companies put out. A lot bigger, parts of the bikes. And these bases have a bit of a lip to them. Looks a little more, almost like a mini plinth. That's good. Plenty of them here. Maybe some extra. These are a lot of big ones here. And again, we'll assemble these off camera and show these at the end. Looks like some dice. Looks like some D10s. Only D10s. That's good. Well, not good. I respect any game that will take the jump off of D6. This gives you a good better range and spread on stats, so I like that, like the boldness of that going away from D6. So we have some cards. I always like cards in games, just to make it easier for rules, you know, reference and stuff. It's like Bean Posse rules, Wyatt Earp, Doc Holliday, Ranger Interceptors. These are all good. Again, nothing cheap in this box. Feels very high quality. Looks like there's another box of cards in here. Action and Adventure card decks. Looks like yet more cellophane. Some small cards here. Looks like action points. Looks like they have another deck of cards that can affect what's going on during the game. That's interesting. If you go through that. A template. Is this some kind of spray or scatter template? Feels good. High quality. Again, nothing skimpy about anything in this box. It is clear enough and concise enough. You can hopefully clearly see through it, obviously. We have some chips. It's like a little ruler system for you if you don't have one, so you can play right out of the box. Some condition tokens, obviously. Hazard, stun, hunkered, disordered, on lookout. On lookout, I'm interested in. That's like an Overwatch mechanic. Cover and dug in sort of thing. So yeah, I'm very interested in this. Reading the rule book, maybe getting in the game. So that's all the components. I do believe the plan is right now to paint them live on Twitch, which hopefully we'll have scheduled by the time we release this video. We can put that information in this video so you know if you want to see the stuff painted live on camera. We're gonna take a break while I assemble this stuff, and then we'll show them when they're put together.